Hello, welcome to the Homes and Construction Show. My name is Francis Amokule, your host as usual. So today I'm pleased to introduce to you something that you know but might not know because it's very unique. It's interior design. If you want to upgrade the look of your home, and certainly they say that, you know, how your home looks speaks a lot about who you are. So again, we are with Artec Technologies. We are at Miss Technology. These are experts in office and kitchen furniture. And I'm pleased to tell you that we are back with Judy again on our show to show us how you can properly bring to life interior design courtesy of Artec. So join me as we delve deep into these details. Nice to see you again.
Welcome. This is one of our projects that we've done. You came to the showroom, you saw it on the showroom. Now this is a client's place.
This is a client's place. So guys, we are at a client's place, at Artec's client, or Judy's
Artec client's
place. So we're just going to give you a feel of if you approach them, yeah, and you're telling them you have these ideas that you want to bring to life, and as far as, you know, doing interior design for you, this is a feel of what you may get depending on the money that you have. So take us through what you did here.
This particular client chose the handless type of kitchen. Remember, I talked about handless earlier. Okay? This one chose a handless type. Now, the beauty with handless type is that you can actually get to mix two colors. You have a dominant color, and then you have a splash of color. Now, when you have a splash of color and you have like a wooden floor down, this one brings the
so there is a combination,
of that
contrasting
or something like that. And then remember
the extractor,
the one with the carbon filter inside.
I remember you told me, you said that you can
that one you can
pull,
remove
how
can
do you pull it out?
Out
yeah like
you can
this
pull it out and clean it. This one you only need to clean the three, like once in 3 years.
Then how do you pull it back like that?
Very easy.
Oh, okay.
Very easy.
Is it working now?
No, it's not working.
Not later.
We'll find out when it's working.
Yeah. All right. Okay. So what else?
This
installation.
This is a 6-burner. Normally they come in 4 burners, 5 burners, or 6 burners.
So what's the advantage with this again? Over the rest of the burners.
Now the size depends on the size of the family that you have. If you have a small family, 4 burner will do. If you have a bigger family, a bigger kitchen, 6 burner is the way to go. Now this one again, it gives a clear cut of the ground of the work. Like there are no division in there.
There's not much clutter and a lot to deal with.
There's no clutter at all. So and here you're able to cook as you store your cooking drawers and spoons. Like it's more functional than a standalone.
Okay. So still handleless. Handleless. Okay, this is interesting. So what else?
And then there's the island. Now, you can choose an island to either be a place that you sit on or for an extra cooktop. Now, this client chose an extra cooktop. This is called an induction top. It only uses electricity. In case the gas runs out.
Oh, yeah, this is gas.
In case the gas runs out, you have this for the one that uses electricity.
So it's starch, eh?
It's starch, yes.
Okay.
Starch.
So this I can tell, this finishing is also...
This is wood finish.
Wood finish with a...
With a laminate.
With a laminate.
Yes.
So is this membrane as well?
Yeah, it's membrane.
The same thing here?
Everything is membrane.
Okay.
And then we have the long cabinets for storage.
Okay.
The some that we prefer, like the mechanism I showed you on the
Of pulling,
but the some that just prefer.
Oh, the long cabinets.
Just storage shelves
okay.
on it. And you have that area for the
fridge. Is this as well? Is this also handless?
This is a full cabinet. You have a inbuilt microwave and inbuilt oven.
Okay. So is this, I didn't see this yesterday. Is this something that
you
just came?
Mm-hmm. You didn't see this part. Mm-hmm. There was only this part. Mm. So this one is, this one you buy. This one you provide for, this one the client provides for.
Oh.
So, but you provide the cabinet that fixes it.
Mm. So each client can accessorize based on how they like it.
Based
so.
On their taste.
All right, so. Uh-huh.
And this client prefers to have a dishwasher. Now in every kitchen, if you're going to have a dishwasher, it's always advisable to have a dishwasher next to the sink.
Mm-hmm.
Because of the water piping and all that, it's easier to pipe everything together. So this is a sink.
Mm-hmm.
This is a dishwasher.
So this is a dishwasher.
Yes.
This is a sink.
This is a sink.
Now how does, you know, I don't know how a dishwasher works, so.
That's a sink. It's connected to water and power.
Mm. Oh, so then you put your utensils here.
You
put your utensils there.
Then you put it on.
You wash and then you rinse.
Yeah.
Uh huh. What else? So that is for the, that is it for the kitchen
this
right
is
now.
The kitchen, yeah.
So let's go to the.
Let's go to the bedroom.
The bedroom. Okay.
Now I'll for this particular client wanted some wall panelings on the bedroom to do what?
The wall paneling. Mm-hmm. Is it by the wall paneling you mean
by the wall paneling? I mean these ones.
Oh okay okay uh huh. What role do the wall panelings work? At what point do you use them?
It's for decoration purposes most of the time. Instead of putting wallpaper or hanging photos, some people prefer art, some people prefer wall panels.
So more like simply. So this is a little bit like, it's simple but again classy.
It's simple and classy. It removes the feel of the room.
It gives me the feeling of, you know, more like acts like an acoustic. So there's not much sound. That's echo. There's not much echo in the room.
And also, when you go to most of these hotels, like five-star hotels, mm-hmm. you find such kind of things. Now, you bring that feel of the hotel.
You see, we didn't talk about the beds last, the bedroom last time we met. I just want to understand how much, if I want to do a wall paneling in my bedroom.
It depends on how the much of your room.
So how much, okay, imagine this is the size of my room. How much would it cost me to do this? Approximately.
Again per square meter.
Uh-huh.
At 450.
Per square meter?
Yes, so if this is 4 square meters times 450.
Mm. Yeah. Do the math. Alright, so steel membrane?
Membrane.
This is some cool finishing, eh? It's amazing. And this is not you, yes?
This is not me, but the person that I do this on behalf of the client. If you come and tell me this is the bed that you want, I have a person that will come and
do it for you.
Yeah.
Wow. So basically for you is this and that.
And the wardrobe.
And this is the wardrobe, okay? So this wardrobe is also old. Yeah. Oh my God!
You
haven't finished, eh?
Yes.
Okay.
Are not yet.
So, but is it going to be handless or what?
No. These ones we are going to put handles in them.
This one, eh? Mm. Okay. Same thing here.
Same thing here.
All right. So this is coming soon.
Handles are coming in soon.
Yeah, but it's a very incredible finishing, still membrane. So what's this basically? How would you describe this? This kind of finishing.
This is an antique wood membrane, wood finish.
An antique wood finish.
It has the feel and the look of of old wood.
Mm-hmm, exactly. Sort of like rustic.
It's rustic.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So they are called antique wood.
Mm-hmm.
Now the one in the kitchen that was matte,
mm-hmm.
a matte finish. Combined with an antique finish, the brown part was antique.
That's interesting. So same procedure per square meter.
Per square meter.
Okay.
It's per square meter, 650.
650 per square meter.
Yes.
And then if it is 5 square meters, you do the math.
Right.
Okay. I'll never be poor. Talk to me about the TV unit.
Same material, membrane, wall panel.
Mm-hmm.
The design that the client wanted was this. Now this one he chose to go with mahogany because You see the panels are mahogany, mostly wooden.
So you wanted this to complement that, or that to complement this?
And then this to throw it off a bit also. So he mixed with this.
So let me ask, when you're coordinating colors, and as far as, you know, interior design is concerned, what do you basically look at? Do you look at what role does light come into the equation?
The light comes into the equation.
And the energy as well?
And the energy as well. And then the color, the tiles down, and the colors on the wall. And also the curtains.
So the colors on the wall and the tiles. Mm. So imagine my tiles are this color. Mm. What would you recommend be on my maybe TV set or TV design and whatever?
Man, this is a perfect combination, because this one picks the colors from the wood. All the colors on the wood are picked on this, so it doesn't it's not thrown off.
Okay.
Yeah,
there's a coordination
of colors in there.
So this is dull a little bit. This is light. Then dull.
And then this dullness also is picked.
It's picked up by this.
Yes.
So there's some sort of like complementing of.
And because it's an open area, this lightness picks on the lightness of the
other wall.
Yeah.
Oh wow. Mm-hmm. So does that have to do with? Does it bring any energy, like feeling or brighten the room? Or
it brightens the room, number one, and it makes the home feel more fancy.
Yeah, I can tell. There's a lot of class here.
So when you do all this, that's when you decide now on the kind of lightings that you're going to use for your house, the kind of curtains that you have. Yeah.
Because I can see the curtains are a little bit dull. So I imagine this complements, that makes, brings some light onto the curtains.
But then you can also see the source of the natural light is really big. So yeah, these curtains are
when they're opened,
the light that comes in is
amazing. It's just like too much, huh? Okay. That's interesting. The chandeliers are actually very amazing, and I know they're not done by you, but it's some amazing work up there.
It's beautiful, even the way they just decorated up there.
Okay, so we're going up?
We're going up.
Okay. These are children's room, eh?
Children's room.
Okay.
The client chose the paneling on the walls. And then in the bed, the beds we made them actually. So you have the two beds for the two kids.
There's this one. This is for the.
This is a box for putting.
Storage
box.
So
you have that. You have the study area.
For the children still.
For the children, yeah.
Okay. Steel membrane. Oh,
steel
storage. Up.
Now in this room they chose. Just to go with an antique color,
yeah.
With
this maroon. I mean, it's gray, light gray, what?
With a matte color, a light gray matte color, and an antique color. And they, you see how they combine.
Yes, so this is a little bit bright. This is a little bit dull. So there's not much brightness going on, but there's still complementation. How is it outside? Oh, yeah. Okay.
So there's that for like a 10-year-old, 11-year-old.
Yeah, I can see the tiles also sort of like look like the this is the antique finishing. Yeah, so it's complemented by the color of the tiles plus these two. So yeah, it looks like nothing was done by mistake. Yeah, same for this.
That is the wardrobe.
Okay.
And then we go through a younger children's room. Bunk beds. Bunk beds. Yes.
You climb. This is like which class? Sit.
This is like.
Easily break these beds. The client will come and find the bed broken. So yeah, same finishing here as well. This is antique.
Antique.
With membrane. Okay.
Yeah.
Amazing. Same finish. This one is matte gray. Is it matte gray or matte?
Matte gray.
Matte gray.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Same thing again, you know. The tiles almost look like this, like this antique color, so nothing was really done by mistake. It's amazing work you guys are doing here. So if you really want this kind of work, you know.
If you have young children and you are afraid that they'll fall off their beds, you have that.
So they sleep safety. Again, wall paneling. Oh, this client wants panels, man. You know, panels a little bit, I like it for the fact that there's some sort of simplicity, but again, there's a lot of class behind it. That's interesting.
So now we go to a home office.
Oh, this is a home office?
Yes, this is a home office.
Wow. So what's the idea here?
When you walk in, you can even feel it's a bit...
Office-ish.
It has a lot of furniture, but it's a bit light also.
That is mostly because of the glasses. The glasses make it look like it's a light place, yeah? This is the color that you chose.
Wow. Get that outside.
Normally what you do with rooms like this, because normally... originally, this was a bedroom. This was supposed to be a bedroom.
Oh.
And then he wanted a home office.
Mm-hmm.
So what we did as architect, we came, we took the measurements, then we did the designing with the client, and this is what came out.
Okay.
So if you have a space in your home that you feel like you want to turn it into anything, just come to us with the idea with it, and then we give you the design. We give you the suggestion.
You customize it based on the need.
Yes.
Okay. That's amazing.
This client, this is the one that's putting it over
the back.
This is a back storage cabinet. These ones are shoe racks.
This client must be a very serious shoe lover. These are all shoe racks.
All that is shoe rack. All this is jewelry and belts and ties.
Jewelry, belts and ties. So you're saying these are?
These are walk-in closet. With a sliding wardrobe in it.
Wow. So this finishing is different. You notice that this is the only place I've seen it, right?
Yeah, this is a different color.
So what's
some,
this?
Some people prefer that the whole house has a different finish, but the best that the building gets its own kind of
finish. Okay. Yeah. So what color is this? What finishing is this?
Still antique.
Antique, okay.
Wood finish.
Okay.
Now he chose this and he went with the wood finish of the crayon.
Definitely. So just walk in, slide, pick your thing, slide. Same thing here. Oh, sorry. Slide. So this slides back this side, right? All right. Instruction again. There you go. Pick your clothes, pick your shoes. Eh, no, no shoes this side. Shoes that side. And then you just close it, dress up, and then you don't need to go. By the time you walk out of the closet, you're already done. Wow, this is amazing. Is that a bathroom? Did you do anything in the bathroom too? Okay. That's it?
That's it.
Oh. This is a balcony where the big man can look at the future. In future. Alright. This is amazing. Amazing, amazing work. In the bedrooms, we've seen the children rooms. Everything. The office and everything. But now, I need to know. At what point should I start planning for this kind of work?
If you are constructing, when you've done the tiles, that's when you're ready for us.
When you've done the tiles, that means...
But then before you even start constructing,
this
should be in your mind. So when you buy the land, you should also decide what kind of furniture you're going to put in it. It's the last bit in construction, but it should also be in plan.
Yeah. Yeah. So it's part of finishing.
It's part of finishing. It's the last bit that comes in the house after the construction, after the tiling, after you've put up your windows. Mm-hmm. Now you're ready for me. You're ready for us.
All right. Mm-hmm. So let's say I have already paid you the money right now. We've started. I've given you the money today, which is
60%.
Yes, six. You take 60%.
60%.
So let's say that I've given you money today to start doing this work. This is October. When should I expect my work to be done? Or what do you base on to determine the timeline?
3 weeks. In three weeks, the whole house is done.
So how long have you taken to do this house?
3 weeks.
3 weeks.
Whole furniture, everything, 3 weeks, mm-hmm. we are done and installed.
Okay.
Yeah.
So for someone that is watching out there right now, I need you to give them your parting shots. And as far as, because right now you're speaking this in position of Artek, there's someone out there that has looked at this and they've admired, and they've sort of like visualized themselves owning this. Like myself, I've told you, I'll never be poor because I plan to own such. What would you tell them?
Every dream is possible.
Mm-hmm.
What you dream, what you visualize, it's possible. You come to us. The prices that I've given might sound very big,
mm-hmm.
but we at Artek, we have plans even on how we do our work. If you come to us and you tell me, did you see, this is the kitchen I want, this is my dream, I want to support your dream.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I want it's beautiful living like this, and I want you to have that in your house. So we come up with a payment plan.
Oh, wow.
And come and tell me, okay, Judy, now work for me, this is my space, go do the measurements, do the designing, give me the quotation. The quotation has come to 30 million. Can we come up with a payment plan? Yes, we do that.
Mm-hmm.
We'll be like, maybe per month, you do what? You
deposit a certain amount.
You deposit a certain amount per month until we reach your 60%.
And then you start the work.
Mm-hmm. Then I come and install.
Yeah. Then you continue.
So we don't want, we are not closing anyone out. We do not want to close anyone out. Like you said, you're starting up, and you feel like, I'm starting up, I cannot save enough to, we don't want to close anyone out. Everybody is welcome. We will work with your budget, within your budget, and within our budget, we will come with a solution. That's for sure.
All right. So guys, we are from the inside kitchen right into the outside kitchen, ready to explore the differences between, what are the differences between the inside and outside kitchen? And of course, I am ready with the food. Eh? So madam, again, just take us through what differences are between the inside and the outside kitchen. This is outside. Does the design change based on the environment? The kitchen design?
Not really, but then most times you find in most homes the outside kitchen is the heavy kitchen. It's where a lot of work happens. Mm-hmm. Here takes place. Here it's also the kitchen that if you have employees in your house managers in your house, it's the kitchen that they normally use. Or if you have guests and you want to do cooking in big numbers, is where it happens. I found that here in Uganda especially, the main kitchen house is different from the outside kitchen house. Probably because of the kind of food that is here.
Also smoke.
The food that is prepared here is a bit more heavier.
Oh.
Like
beans.
For example, in Kenya, our meals are very
light.
Light. So you only need one.
Sukumawiki and ugali.
Ugali, and you have a meal here. You need matoke, ugali, mchele, what you
call that. Potatoes. Yeah.
So this is an outside kitchen. Now the difference between this and that kitchen is, this is going to be a handle kitchen, a kitchen that we have handles.
Mm-hmm. The other one was handleless,
The other one was handleless.
Why?
Client's choice.
Preference. Oh, okay.
Yes. So, this is how it looks like. This is going to be the spice area.
Yeah.
And then...
Virungo.
Yeah.
Virungo area, okay.
That's a storage.
Okay.
Still, the appliances are still the same.
This is different from the other one.
They're still the same, but just the shape of it is different. Oh. The other one is much more elegant, much more
But still, someone's preference.
Okay.
So the appliances are still the same.
You can still open?
You can still open.
Oh.
Yeah.
It's the same. All right. So, Sam, how much does this thing cost, this one here?
1.2, depends on the size.
All right. Is the same price with the other one, or this one is a bit more
This is a bit cheaper than the other one.
Oh.
Yeah.
All right. Is the price tag for setting up this particular kitchen any different from the other one?
Yeah. This is a bit cheaper.
Oh.
It has handles. The other one is handled with a bit.
Like, how much is it?
Like, this one probably would cost you around 10 million. 8 to 10 million.
Mm.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So I can see there's also this.
Even the design is different now.
Design is more simplistic?
It's more simplistic, more different. You see, now you have just an oven cabinet alone without the microwave.
Mm-hmm.
Then you have that goes down to the sink area,
mm-hmm.
that goes to the cut granite.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So it's more simplistic and cheaper.
Yeah.
Okay. Has been 30 minutes of informative information in as far as interior design is concerned, and as you can tell, we've shared information as far as, you know, what you need to know before you can start interior design for your kitchen, for children's room, master bedroom, name it. You'll find it here on the Homes and Construction Show. And remember, our aim is not only to give you pictures or video, but it's to help you make very good decision, because like they say, your interior design or whatever you have in your house says a lot about who you are and as far as your personality is concerned. So if you need information or planning or guidance as far as decision making is concerned, Judy will be able to help you to, you know, bring your dreams to life. And she said that in case you're skeptical about your affordability and as far as the pricing is concerned, they have a payment plan whereby you can deposit your money up to 60%, upon which they will commence, you know, to start designing for you. And most of the time, it doesn't take long. It's between 2 to 3 weeks, right? 2 to 3 weeks, and you have your dream interior design. I hope that has been helpful for you. My name is Francis Mukule, and this is the Homes and Construction Show here on Urban TV.